God remembered Noah and every within him and all the captives that was with him in the ark, and God made a wind to pass over the earth, and the waters assuaged the fountains on the earth, the deep and the windows of heaven were stopped, and the rain from heaven was restrained, and the waters returned from off the earth continually. And after the end, the 150 days, the waters were abated, and the ark rested in the seventh month of the 17th day of the month above the mountains, Ararat, and waters priest continually until the 10th month, in the 10th month on the first day of the month were the tops of the mountains seen, and it came to pass at the end of 40 days that Noah opened the window of the ark which he had made, and he sent forth a raven which went forth to and fro until the waters were dried up from off the earth. Also he sent forth a dove from heaven to see if the waters were abated from the face of the ground, but the dove found no rest for the sole of her foot, and she returned unto him into the ark, for the waters were on the face of the whole earth, and he forced his hand toward her and pulled her in unto him into the ark, and he stayed yet a certain days, and again he sent forth a dove out of the ark, and the dove came into him in the evening, and lo, in her mouth was an olive leaf plucked off. So Noah knew that the waters were abated from off the earth, and he stayed yet a certain days, and sent forth a dove which returned not again unto him anymore, and it came to pass in the 601st year, in the first month, the first day of the month, the waters were dried up from off the earth, and Noah renewed the covering of the ark, and looked, and behold, the face of the ground was dry, and in the second month on the 720th day of the month was the earth dried, and God stayed unto Noah, saying, go forth. because he art thou, and thy life and thy sons and thy sons' lives with thee. Bring forth with thee every within that is with thee of all flesh, both of fowl and of cattle and of every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth, that they may breed abundantly in the earth, and be fruitful and multiply upon the earth. And Noah went forth, and his sons, and his wife, and his sons' wives with him, every beast, every creeping thing, and every fowl, and whatsoever creepeth upon the earth. Their times went forth of thee, and Noah built an altar unto the Lord, and took of every clean beast, and of every clean fowl, and offered burnt offerings on the altar, and Lord's men sweet savour. And the Lord said in his heart, I will not again curse the ground any more for man's sake, for he in that time of man's heart is evil from his youth. Neither will I again smite any more everything living as I had done, while the earth remaineth seed time and harvest and cold and heat and summer and winter and day and night shall not see.